Today we are out for a race for MultiGP qualifying for the local area of Tampa. And I think we got this course right. It's okay. So everyone's all lined up, ready to go.
Pilot standby.
Pilot standby. Some fun now. Okay, so now it's a few days after we did the racing out at the Cigar City Multi Rotors for the MultiGP 2019 qualifying track. And I've had a chance to look at the footage and man, I'm excited. So I'm pretty much typically a doubting Thomas, okay? I don't believe everything, I question everything. You know, I'm one of those people that just, you know, until I see proof, I don't believe it. That's because, you know, question everything, man. Question authority. I'm a rebel. Shush. So I'm more or less, I have to see the wounds in Jesus' hands and go, holy crap, those were big nails, Jesus. Now that I've got my fingers bloody from poking wounds on Jesus' hands, you know, you think they would have healed up by now, right? It's only been 3,000 years. I can now tell you, I am a true believer. And the DRL Sim was my experimental area that I wanted to explore. Not because of any other reason than they just updated the physics, and to me, in the simulator, it felt pretty good. That said, before the update to the physics, this is how I was flying gates. I know, right? Hard to believe because I look just like a MultiGP pilot, don't I? I know. I was born this way. Sexy, bearded, MultiGP pilot. But I did sleep in a Holiday Inn Express last night, so I don't know if that really had so much to do with it either. Because, believe it or not, people, it's a fact that works. Go stay in a Holiday Inn Express and then go build a building somewhere. You'll see. You'll see. You'll thank me. Wanted to say this is progress over 4 to 6 weeks since the update to the physics. Previously, when 2.0 was out, I was actually doing pretty good, but of course the physics were not what the physics are now in DRL Simulator. And I typically rely on the simulator so I don't have to spend a lot of money. Okay, I'm a cheap lot, you know, so what? I don't want to spend money like you do. You know, I've got a lot of strippers to support through college. Someone's got to do it. After the first couple weeks, I went out and flew again, and here's my result. I was at a race down in Sarasota with good old Judd Skins, whatever the last name is. He does the SRQ racing down there. And as you can see me flying, yeah, okay, I'm avoiding the gates, but I got those flags down straight, huh? So you can see tentatively I was starting to kind of get the muscle memory to do this stuff. Then about a week and a half, 2 weeks later, I went out with the Cigar City folks, people at some park that they had found, and we set up some gates, and then I started to feel like, you know, holy crap, I'm getting this. That's half my problem. There's always a voice in the back of my head going, wow! And I'm like, stop that! As you look at some of this footage, you can see, yeah, okay, yeah, maybe I am getting this. I need a little more practice on some of my, you know, wide turns where you have to circle around stuff, but, you know, I'm doing okay. So now the full update of the DRL Sim came out, where it went from beta to production, and I started flying more, and, you know, lucky for me, and maybe you, I don't know, you might not think so, but I think so, they put the MultiGP 2019 course inside DRL. MultiGP course is nothing to, you know, sneeze at. Well, I guess you can sneeze. I hope someone says God bless you, but they probably won't. Who are you to order God around, right? But they're not timid tracks, okay? I am not a racer. I'm a guy who likes to fly a drone. That's all there is to it. And I like to race because there's more racing going on than there is Bando. Unfortunately, there's an undue risk with Bando in Florida where, believe it or not, some people are like, you're a trespasser, you're going to jail. And we're like, we're just flying, man. Now, I put a lot of hours in between the last time we were at the park with Cigar City until they set up their course for a MultiGP 2019 practice race. And that, you know, Dave, the coordinator, was kind enough to let me take a couple laps on it to see how I'm doing in the sim. And I appreciate it very much, Dave. Thank you very much. I also, as we get into this, I want to say I also asked my friend Andrew if he would fly a couple rounds on his GoPro so we have a little bit clearer than DVR. Not that I'm a fan of DVR, but, you know, GoPro is a little bit better than DVR. That much. So Andrew flew the course for me, and I attempted to match it, and I think I did pretty good in the simulator as to how it flies. Now let me give the setup for aircraft for you so you understand where we're what we're working with. Because my favorite aircraft in real life to fly is a 4-inch I call Tango Dose, I needed to match that same aircraft with as close to the motors as I could get at present, because DRL's always adding more motors. I set up the tweaker in sim, in the DRL sim. That is also a 4-inch versus my Catalyst Machine Works 4R, I think I call it. I call it Tango Dose. That's all I need to qualify. In the DRL Discord, they have an area called Show Me Your Rates. So I looked at a lot of those rates because they don't pretend to be a genius on rates either. I know what they're for. I have the theory stuck in my head. But does that mean I'm going to make the atom bomb? Here's a project. Back to the rates. So I looked at a bunch of people's race, and I've seen them fly. I'm always on the DRL stream watching those guys because there's always good information from that. In fact, DRL has started their own YouTube channel where you can probably gain some knowledge from, and it will be linked down below. You follow them at AllMonkeyDance, and you go subscribe to that DRL Sim video channel on YouTube, and you may be a multi-GP pilot or DRL racer, like, really soon. Like it might be amazingly overnight. Oh, I don't want you to hope so. Work on it, then get back to me. Back to the rates. I went in, I looked at rates, I played with them in the sim, I found something I felt comfortable with, and I kept those as rates. I then transferred those rates over to my real life drone, Tango Dose. In fact, I put it on two other ones, Joker and Herbert. And I had it all ready to go. I took it out for a test flight. It felt great, felt like the simulator, which made me quite happy. One of the other things that DRL Sim has by default that I don't do is I don't fly a 5S battery, I fly a 4S battery. I'm older. It takes me a little bit longer to react. You know, shush, you're gonna get there one day and you're gonna be like, ow, my elbow hurts, ow, why? Because you're old. Now we have the scenario, my PIDs, you're probably asking, what about your PIDs? I just followed the PIDs I got from NERC. He listed some PIDs that he called Rate Bank 2. Or some kind of bank 2 on a racer free from DRL itself. So I said, nah, what the heck, I'll try them. Because again, not a PID genius. I know the theory, but you know, as far as I'm concerned, they work because there I am flying with them. So we're good there. So now we have all the ingredients to go and take a test. What I'm gonna do in this next test, pretty soon I'll get to shut up and you'll be like, oh, thank God that guy's not talking again. We're gonna do my race against myself in both the simulator and in real life using the MultiGP course as our guide to get through. And then Andrew, like I said earlier, flew like an amateur, and great job on that, Andrew. You really fooled me. Wow, you look like an amateur on that. I'm gonna follow Andrew's flying, and I'm gonna duplicate it or try and reduplicate it in the sim, and we'll see how we do with that. Spoiler alert, it didn't suck. So, you know what's coming. Let's go fly!
Left at the mall cause your mama forgot. I know it hurts. Pants. I know it hurts. Kicked out on- seem to be fine.
I'm feeling crazy now, I'm really crazy now. But you and me should just break it all out. You're not alone in this, but now you're on your own. I forgot about your smile, yeah, it has been a while. Something made you unhappy, it's gone. I think that none of us did wrong, but we
Now, in the video that we have from both the sim and the real life, there were some times where, in order to keep the video in sync, I had to cut out some of my bumps and bruises. Because for me, it was my first time flying in real life like that, and there was a bunch of people watching me, making me nervous, touching my ear while I'm flying, that there was a little more than when I'm sitting at home with headphones and music blasting in my ears and sitting in my comfortable chair. So in order to keep those two as much as in sync as possible, I did do a little clipping here and there just to take out something and I didn't crash in the sim, but I did crash in real life, you know, because somebody was messing with my ear or something. So I did do some clipping like that. And at one point, my battery had fallen out in real life and it was dangling, and I had some things going on because of the change in CG or balance of the aircraft. So now, there you go. Done. You can't argue with the video. Okay, you could, but it's a losing battle, man. Just give up now. The video don't lie. That's right, it don't lie. And you can see that the physics in DRL Simulator hold up, I want to say, probably 99.8% accurate. And I have to say it that way because I don't know if I'm doing something wrong and the simulator is reacting differently to what I'm doing, or, you know, it's just me. You know, you never want to blame yourself. You want to blame someone else, and I'll blame the simulator because I'm perfect. Now, what would be really great, if you guys are a doubting Thomas like me, I'm gonna save you from getting blood on your fingers as you're poking holes in Jesus' hands, and go out and set up a small course and maybe find something similar. We'll first look in DRL, see if there's a simple course you could set up out in the real world, and then go fly it if you've had the experience of practice inside the simulator. If you go out and do that and record both your simulator and your real life stuff, I would love to see it, okay? So just don't be afraid to leave a link down below comparing the two. It's just, it would just be my greatest hope that I'm not the only one. You know, I'm not some freaking alien going, bring me to your leader. Okay, I am, but bring me to your leader. But I wanna see you do good as well. So that said, end the video. Nothing else to say. Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida. See you.